Okay, so now I'd like to introduce Hamlet, Isaxanli, who will talk about higher education in Azerbaijan between heritage and modern times.
System, particularly this in my case in Azerbaijan. It's not too easy to say what is education system for small size countries, because the modern trends, not only modern trends, in all time it was that small size countries education system was part of wider system. Let me say, in the period of Middle Ages, Azerbaijani education system was just part of Islamic civilization. It's so-called maktab madrasa systems, high school and higher education. And in the period of division of Azerbaijan between Russia and Persia, so-called Russian period, it was, of course, a very mixed education system. It was religious education. It was secular education. It was mixed, so-called Russian-Tatar schools, and so on. It was some kind of transition from Middle Ages into modern European type of education. Then it was 2 years independence, too short to establish something, but anyway it was established Baku State University, and hundred students were sent to Europe for their higher education. Then Soviet Azerbaijan, it is our second republic, we'll say, it was of course Azerbaijan education, just as it was Soviet education, just few changes concerning Soviet republics, some language policy and so on. And then modern period, higher education, I'm concentrated more on higher education. Of course it was again a challenge where to go, because we have some heritage, some Soviet legacy, which was very powerful, and at the same time looking for United States, for Europe, maybe for Far East, where to go. At the beginning it was some American trends, and then these countries have joined to so-called Bologna process, correctly to Bologna process, where applying some credit accumulation system and quality indicators concerning European education system. General picture for Azerbaijani education system, we have just now 52 universities and higher learning colleges. Many of them are state universities, and 13 we have private higher education institutions. There are some big diversity. There is so-called classic universities, including art, sciences, sometimes law, mostly specialized higher learning education in different areas, technical, teacher training, languages, and so on, many concerning security, military education. They are not affiliated with the Ministry of Education, they have their own affiliation. A few comprehensive universities. I know at least three universities in Azerbaijan, two of them are private, newly established, and one state university in Nakhchivan, which have many areas like engineering, arts, humanities, education, and so on. National Academy of Sciences in former Soviet countries, they have different trends. In Azerbaijan, this organization is the same with same type of degree, a PhD and then Doctor of Science degree. But now their idea is that probably becoming research-oriented university, introducing some new programs. We have two foreign-based institutions. One is Lomonosov Moscow State University branch. Another one is Turkish Foundation University, represented by here. Probably a third is coming because recently our president of country has met delegation from France. They have idea establish some new French university. Concerning challenges in education, I think everywhere in higher education system we have at least three type of problems. One is to increase access to higher education. Second is not just higher education, but increase quality of higher education. Third trend is it's government trends, not increase state expenditure, even sometimes cut. And you see, it is very complicated because these challenges are contradicting each other. You are cutting financing and looking for quality for access to higher education. For the beginning, it was decline of enrollment in Azerbaijan higher education. It was one of the lowest in Soviet among former Soviet countries. Then it was increasing slowly. Just now it's about 25%. It is low, not so high. All our neighbors, not only neighbors in Caucasus, but wider their access to higher education is higher. What is the matter? The government idea is that if increase rapidly, it will be not quality education. It's a big, big debate. You are not so happy with this idea, but because it is a government supported, there is organization, Central Admission, Student Admission Committee. University will apply for student admission committee, they will send certain number of students. So even private universities have no right to increase number of programs, number of students. You have to negotiate with government. Concerning legislation within higher education, in general education system, we have during the independent period two education law. First one was very interesting because it introduced very new ideas for me, including bachelor and master degree, university, some kind of autonomy for universities. Next one was more conservative, last one. And it also was some amalgam of Soviet and Western system. So in the country we have PhD, at the same time we have a Doctor of Science degree, and according to this law of education, main idea of law of education is that to solve your problem, you have to go to some state agency which was not named within their law. So you have to look for what kind of state agency. Recently, Azerbaijan president has signed state strategy on the development of education. For the first time, it is in this very wonderful document. How we'll implement it, I don't know. But this document main points are contradictory to last education law, supporting some university in campus building, in credits, in autonomy, in independence, and so on and so on. So we're waiting, we're acting and waiting in this direction. at the beginning of our new period, it was some two major trends. How to reform education system. One was that you have to change slowly education system totally. It's not so easy, you cannot do it quickly because it's a very complicated system. Another idea was that establishment of new educational institution which has no positive, no negative background, and they may apply new type of educational model. One was first one was Khazar University. I was founder of this university. It was last year of Soviet Union, beginning of independence. It paved new way for itself and probably for the Azerbaijan. Now we'll move into quality. Say a few words. Everywhere there are at least three candidates to looking who is responsible for quality. First is institution itself, because internal evaluation culture is very important. If university or higher learning college has well established internal quality system, they may have some indeed chance to develop, establish some real quality assurance system. Second is government. Third is independent accreditation agencies. In Azerbaijan, we have no independent accreditation agency. Accreditation agencies, at the beginning, it was affiliated with Council of Ministers. Now it is affiliated with Minister of Education. Only positive moment is that before it was accreditation created only for private universities. To go to private university and solve the problem, to be or not to be in general. Accreditation was not just some kind of diagnostics and define good financial funding policy. It was just open, closed type of system. But now accreditation system is working for state universities as well. Recently they visited two state universities. It was quite strong, evaluation. We have too many government agencies that are responsible for education. I gave a list of them. So each university, at least you have to be in touch with some five, six of them. Sometimes you don't know where to go. In general, probably I'm not right person to represent Azerbaijani government view, because I'm in general criticizing, but same is doing Minister of Education now. It's easy to criticize than give some kind of advice or give a list of where to go. Anyway, main challenge is that no real independence or autonomy in education system. We have centralized admission plan, admission of students. It was very good because it was anti-corruption measure at the beginning of our independence. But at the same time, now it is too centralized. University not taking part any, they have no any fort to in decision making of admission. Also, universities to start new majors, including private university, you have to apply for government. It will be not easy in many cases. Negotiators. Same diploma granting is for all universities. It's again a legacy of Soviet time that the Minister of Education is responsible for granting diploma. We have you need diploma form, you will apply for Minister of Education, they will send commission, they will look if all is okay, and then they will send for some education, some diploma for all universities. And at the same time, I have to note that many universities, higher education institutions neglect quality control. Many of them have no quality assurance system. Few of them, two private universities, I know exactly, Khazar University and Caucasus University, they have a well-established quality assurance system. And two state universities, they are just establishing this system. I will say a few words about size and material capacity of universities, higher education institutions in Azerbaijan. At the beginning of independence, it was everywhere in Azerbaijan, Armenia and Georgia, it was some higher education institutions have mushroomed in some kind of private universities. In Azerbaijan, it was not so much because it was just 15 universities, country president said, it's enough. Not regulation, but just by law. He said, it's enough for probably 15 is enough. I know that, but in Georgia and in Armenia, it was much more. Now, Azerbaijan, there is another tendency. Now, state universities, small size state universities have mushroomed very much. Some 15 years ago, it was some 25 state university, 15 private universities. Just now we have 49 state universities, 13 minus 2 private universities. Sometimes our government agencies are very interested just having their own institution of higher learning, particularly ministries and other institutions. Of course, in the world, there is another tendency, just if you like for Japan, they have announced it in 2001 that they have 99 public national universities. Their idea was increase it until it will be 65, because bigger university will have much more opportunity to develop campuses, libraries, and so on and so on, to do research. Develop some corporate, university corporate work relations and so on. Same idea now in Russia, they are organizing so-called federal universities in different places, research-oriented universities, merging, joining different universities, and increasing funding of this type of university. in Azerbaijan, at the beginning, it was just Soviet type of funding, sending to state university funding, and they will use it according to budget. But now it was big struggle from university side. Now they're funding per capita students. So students will receive government money, and they have a right to go to private university or maybe to state university with this money. It's per capita funding was good system. Unfortunately, we are discussing within our parliament loan system, how to support students. We have very good state abroad program, but inside of country, too long discussion and no decision concerning loan system. Situation is not so good also in knowledge economy and university industry relations areas because most universities are not research oriented. If you are not research oriented, you will not it will not easy to be global in education. Few universities are now developing industrial corporate world university technopark, and most to private universities have some success in this areas. Universities are trying to increase enrollment, and in this way increase their capital, their finances, but not looking to increase the endowment for research, for university industry relations. Also concerning tax system, has exploited value-added tax, but we have profit tax. It's a little strange because private universities are not for profit, non-profit universities, but there is a profit tax policy and system. I'm coming to the end. Yeah, I will, even 1 minute earlier, I will try. Concerning academic research, which is very important, it's not a successful area in Azerbaijan. We have no real reform of academy of science system, as well as support to research of higher education. And dissertation defense concept is old-fashioned, as was in Soviet times, so some 20-25% coming together for 10 majors, fixed concept. Centralized approval of scientific research degrees by higher attestation committee. They are in general responsible for quality of PhD programs. Quality of PhD program is a problem everywhere, even in the United States. It's a big discussion how to evaluate PhD programs. Publications is low if we compare in Soviet time. We have in the country only two journals indexed by Web of Science top surveyors. First one is Applied and Computational Mathematics at Baku State University. And second, Khazar Journal of Humanities and Social Sciences. Recently, this year, it included into top surveyors. It's by Khazar University Press. At the end, because I said I'm not representative of the Minister of Education, but at the same time, I have to note some positive trends anyway. We have oil, it's our wealth and problem sometimes. So government has a very ambitious plan, turning black gold into human gold. They did in some good step, some years, no. But anyway, educators are not happy that many words, no less actions. At the same time, I think establishment of private sector, centralization, some anti-corruption measure concerning admission system, development of physical plant of higher education system, highly developed now in Azerbaijan. Publication of books financed by government, salary increase, every 2 years some salary increase, all time it's not enough. It's some kind of close to inflation rate. VAT exemption, it was very good for education system, per capita financing, study abroad program, and one government grants. Now, indeed, in Azerbaijan, let me say, for my university, Khazar University, each year we have received some 10-12 government grants for different projects, competition based, for training of high school teachers, and so on and so on. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Hamlet. That was a very interesting and very frank description of the situation in Azerbaijan, and I think raises one of the issues that all Caucasian or South Caucasian governments face, and that is the relationship between the state and higher education, and certainly Georgia has not been exempt from that problem. The previous administration in particular had some, let's say, very strong centralizing tendencies when it came to higher education. So this is a very important problem. It's that relationship between the state and the autonomy and independence of the university. And I hope we will discuss that in the discussion. So thank you very much. That was a very interesting talk.